Wholeness and Balanced Vibrations family. I trust you well. I am Curtis Aru, the reflection of you, and I'm here to vibe with you. Much love, family. All right, so with all that's going on in the world right now, yeah, you gotta dance. You gotta have some joy in your soul to move forward. That's your inner force. That's your terrestrial oomph that you get from the ancestors that you tap directly into source right here in that solar. Not too high, not too low, but right there in the middle. Feels good. So, coming to you live, and this is going to be short because it's actually been like 7 hours. Hear me again. 7 hours leading up to this video that so many obstacles, friction, but that let me know I got to get this out. I got to do it because I was like, you know what? Fuck it, I'll do it tomorrow. I'll do it another day. I got other stuff to do. Night. The sun is about to beat me on. Or the moon is about to beat me on. 7 hours. So I ain't even going to dive into that. Today came to bring you a message, bring you some energy so you can find a little bit more balance within the flux of what's going on, because I'm a reflection of you. And if I can give you just an inkling of a little balance, peace, joy, wholeness, allow me. So I'll start by saying our goal is a tree, call and response, basically just asking for permission for, do you hear me? You say, I say, I go. You say, I may. I go, I may. I go, I may. To the most, one, some of the most polite people you meet in the world, in Ghana, the Twi people that ask before they enter your home or before they come into a space, they might say, I go, meaning, will you hear me? Will you hear the words I have to say? Are you listening? Are you home? Will you receive me? All these things. And you respond by saying, I may. You may listen. You have my ear. Talk to me. All those things. So, I go. Thank you. Amen. As we proceed to give you what you need, and truth is on in the recipe for the harmony, for the preparation, for the food, for the soul, how you are about to receive, and I plan to give. And today is a gratitude day. Because you got to start off with gratitude. You got to start off in honor of the space that you're in. And I do this by honoring the mother. Take a breath with me. You know, give me some tunes too, because it won't take long. Every breath needs a song, you know. Even if there's some tones, like a golden frequency behind you. They're going to rock to that. Taking this time in the now moment to connect, that's all we truly have. This is a space given to us, a gift of the present, and I hold space for you right now to dial it in. Feel the breath. Something we often take for granted in our haste. And that you still have the breath. And that's all the vehicle you need. Vehicle you need to move further inside self to grasp what you may have forgotten. They say your wisest thoughts lives at the bottom of your lungs. So deep dive. Go get them. Come back up. It may take some time. But music happens within the rest. So breathe as you speak. And let it flow. Alright, so as it's going wild out here in the world, we got viruses going wild. We got financial systems crumbling. We got spiritual teachers and a number of other beliefs and ideologies are losing traction. Losing traction is people like, no, I ain't going there no more. I don't do that no more. And I'm done. Like, there's something intuitively happening when people are becoming more aware and expanding their awareness. I mean, don't say consciousness. I don't anyway. I try to say awareness, something that's more dialed into the space because I'm awake, conscious. But expanding my awareness of what I know to be true. And this continues to flower. It continues to blossom the deeper you go into self. The more experiences you have, the more you can come from the heart space and receive people as they are. And leave judgment behind. Because when you bring it with you, bag lady, you're going to hurt your back. Your back is that Kundalini route highway up to the spine, up to the young ram right here in the back. That corpus callosum back there, superior brachium, right back here. So let it flow. Drop those bags. Let go to judgment. Do a little dance. Don't let it get you. You know, there's this beings out here who are directly in charge. Like, they clock in to fuck up your day. Like, this is, yes, we won again. No, you can't let it. Those distractions that come through, those people who throw something at you, they ain't even them. Forgive them because they know not what they do. They don't even know what they're saying. A lot of people are blink behind the eyes. They're glossed over. They're doing the same thing they've done as long as they can remember. And they say what the elders say, if you've always done what you've always did, you'll always get what you've always gotten. And if you like what you got, keep the cycle going. It's a circle, a cycle. You're going crazy, insane in the membrane. Don't let it happen. Take the breath. Stop right there. Be grateful for the moment. Be aware. Don't get played. You're the player in the game. You got the console. You got the controller. You just have to sit back in the driver's seat, you know, stretch out a bit and get the moving. All right, so coronavirus. You wish it sounded like that, right? It's sounding like hysteria right now. How do you protect yourself from the coronavirus? Yeah, know thyself. Proverb. Actionable. Know thyself. This is something you have to continue to do. Like, it's, you're continuing to blossom, continue to flower, continuing to grow and shift in new days, new moments. How to stop the moment, how to dial back into the space that you belong to, the source, the energy. Take a step back. Get some hand sanitizer. But really, it's an alarm for you to focus on your health. How are you feeling today? What are you eating? What are you drinking? Are you drinking enough water? Are you eating the proper diet to sustain your body? Things that you want to complete, things that you want to do. Are you exercising? Or do you have already health issues? If not, awesome. Let's get some things in there to sustain this proper growth in this work that you've been doing. These get some new habits in here to get you on and popping. Like get your functions rocking optimally. You know, as we drink water, you want to make sure we have half your body weight in ounces. You're drinking. You're 180. You should be drinking 90 ounces of water daily. Like, just getting too used to it. If you don't do it, it's cool. Start. Because I forget to do it sometimes. Like, so just start where you are. Try to create some habits within yourself and make sure you're drinking the correct water. What kind of water are you drinking? Do you know what's in your water? Like, tap water ain't it. Especially if you're in the States, like in the U.S. Tap water ain't it. So, what devices that you have to filter your water? What knowledge or labels say behind the water? Is it alkaline? Is it distilled? Is it reverse osmosis? Is it, what is it? Know this stuff. Know thyself, because this is becoming a part of you as you ingest it. You are what you eat. I am what I am. Continuing. I'm going to make this as quick as possible because, again, It's been 7 hours for me getting here, and I'm going to give it to you raw and straight. So what are we eating? And another thing I just learned from, I think, Dr. Joel Wallace or something like that. But talk about 90 essential minerals and the fact that how when we exercise, we sweat. And those minerals are going right behind it. And if you don't have something with you at the gym or when you get back from the gym to replenish those minerals and nutrients lost within the sweat, the good, the bad, and ugly, doesn't matter. It's coming out of your pores. It's being released. It's being worked out. So you need something to put back in to sustain yourself. We'll dial back into that a little bit later on a longer video. Also, when I said, what are your spiritual, do you talk to yourself? I had a friend who just asked the question, what is it? Meditation versus devotion. And I wanted to dial into that space really quick. Meditation versus devotion. Just think about the words, meditate, meditation, mediate, talk, communicate. You're communicating. When you're in meditation, communicating with self, higher self, God, supreme being within self, all these things, the creator, the mother, you're in communication, you're talking, like as it's firsthand, it's me peer to peer, boom to boom, or boom to boom in a self, like the ship versus the person driving or the being driving the ship. And this is what you're in communication with. This is the sovereign connection. One of many. Devotion. Sounds like devour. Devote. Devote. Vote. Vote. L-O-V-T. It's energy. Devote. Devote. They're taking your energy. That sounds... Devote. So when you're devotion, and I think the word for devotion, etymology of it, takes you back to the meaning of it. Giving all of oneself, or giving all of something into something else. And going into self. Taking from self. Contrast. Boom, boom. So when you're devotion, you're going to devotion, you're giving to an entity. You're giving to giving entity. You're giving to an egregor. You're giving to something that's taking your energy. It ain't say revotion. It's giving and getting ready, but you're taking it. You're just giving it. Pouring of yourself into something else, receiving nothing in it. And that is from the spiritual perspective. You're being depleted. Like same thing with the sweat. You're being depleted. What are you doing to get that back? And this is where you start to separate the dogmas. Things that anything you have to worship, fight. Worship. Because if you're worshiping something, it's something you can't worship. You know, if you're worshiping, if your belief is to this deity, to this God, to this whatever, most of the time, anybody who doesn't feel that way can't go where you go. They can't go to heaven if they don't, you know, worship or believe. And all knees shall bow, Lord, they can't go with you. So now you got an enemy. Now you got a pole. Now you smack back and forth. Good, bad, good, bad, good, bad. Where do I belong? And you're locked within this duality. And come back to the center. Meditation. Center point. Boom. Right there. Come back to self. Not being taken anywhere. And the truth is simple. Lies are complicated. So we try to stick to, not try to, you are, you become truth. I keep moving forward. I think I said give thanks. Want to give thanks. I got to give thanks to the ones who came before me. Got to give thanks to all the ones who poured into me. I got to give thanks for all those who connected. And just share the hug, just to share a hug. You know, breathe, meditate, high five, lend me, you know, something. Everybody. I have so many things to be grateful for, and I'm sure you do too. Just this breath I'm grateful for. And typically, pretty much always, when you receive something, you gotta give something. Equal measures. Equal measures. This is the toroidal flow. You see, right here to the right of me. Right of me. The little symbol here with the heart. It's all phi to an adept. It's all phi. And the real heart goes back into itself. Toroidally. Given. You find your whole. You don't find your other half. You are whole. You find someone else who is whole, who is sustaining themselves. They don't need you to, they don't need your love. They would love to connect with somebody who's in love with themselves, but you love you. Find somebody else who love them, and y'all can have a beautiful, beautiful relationship. But this, again, not externally. I'm talking internally. The divine feminine in you, divine masculine in you, coming together for that true merger, that true love. And that's where it's at. Not the Disney. No, I'm waiting for my Prince Charming. La 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 la. Nah, that's not it. You are supreme in oneself. And as you find that within yourself, you attract others who need that lesson, which is everybody. Everybody. And those who are in love with themselves. And this is something that I remember when I actually went back to the gym. I ain't went to the gym in a, it's been a little minute for myself. And I went back and I'm like, I forgot how it feels to do some or do work out in this physical aspect and really do something in the moment that you know that is giving back to you. Know that is giving back to you. This rep, it's all me right here. You know, this time you spend stretching, drinking water, meditation, that all that is like a jewel. This is grateful. You're being grateful. You should be grateful for these moments and take these moments for yourself. And this is how you love yourself. You love yourself so much that you took time to work out. You took time to drink some water. You took time to meditate. You took time to read something new. And learning something new is how we continue to grow. Anything that has life is supposed to grow. If you're stagnant and you're still, you're dead. Your energy is, poof. And once, if you're still, you know, things start to germinate on you. You know, fungus starts to come and these things start to hop on you. And then you start getting heavy and heavy. And before you know it, you're depressed. You're sad. How did I get this way? Because you stayed stagnant too long, baby. You got to shake it off. You got to move. You got to dance. You got to shake it up. You got to raise your vibrations. Come a little closer because the sun is going down outside, so we can get a little more love. And I'm going to make this, speed this up. All right. So another thing I want to be grateful for is those who poured into me. And that is some of my amazing teachers that I've had the awesome opportunity to connect with. And I'm going to list probably a couple of them. Then I'll take you to the site where you can find others that you can dial into. And one of the first ones I got to give a shout out to is my grandparents. Grandparents, no, drop them jewels. Like, yo, you understand it when you get older. and just watching them as they build themselves, build businesses, how they pour into the grandkids, how they conduct themselves in their relationships. My grandmother, and both sets of my grandparents, but yeah, my first teachers and my parents, of course. But want to dive more into the spiritual space, some of the spaces that I've graduated into. Supreme Brother Savan Bomar with Secret Energy. And this brother gave it raw. Raw. Like straight gnosis when I caught up with bro like maybe 5-6 years ago, something like that. And most stuff he said went over my head. What? Arcana? The great arcane? What is that? Archetypes. Archetypes for what? Diving into celestial mechanics and symbolism and language and like mathematics. So many things that I heard and it resonated, but I just couldn't tell you what about it until I dialed it into a space. And dialing into it, just turning it down, looking a little closer, looking a little further into self or into the books that can aid you in a better understanding, giving you that vernacular you need to really navigate through some of these spaces, because you have to be precise with the swords, with the words. And he gave that to me. And those were along with many others. And my bro has a platform that we all are part of now called Secret Energy. And this platform has so much to offer. The first conscious social media platform ever to date is already up and running. We're building it as we go. This site comes with a Jill chat we're going to be launching this year that tells you other conscious people within your space that you can connect with on the same vibe, because you know this can be a lonely road as you're diving into the space of asking questions, expanding your awareness. This is something the masses don't do, but there are many of us. So continue to do it, and you can find more of us on the site. We'll talk more about it as we go through this year, and we drop some updates later. Brother Martin Kinney, supreme brother, great information. Learned quite amount of stuff, especially when it comes to the cosmic calendar, a model he made of the cosmic egg, where took things down into epochs, showing the micros of the macro, and allowing me to visually really see how, because it resonated, see how this planet is made, where we are. I had a teacher used to always ask me, where are we? Where are we in my theater class? Like, where are we? Like, America? You? And then he'd be like, no. And then he was like, just going to this long rant. Like, you don't even know where you are. Where are you? I didn't know he'd really dialed into the space before it was colonialized. What was it called? And we just had these great discussions in class. And again, another great teacher, Brother Brooks. Continue. Flying Lasagna Lady. She is name is Aurora on YouTube. Actually, I'm gonna dive into this in space and go right into it so we can keep flowing. And boom, boom, boom. Sha sha. So right here. Alright. Spiritual advice. This is secretenergy.com right here. And I'll go to the home page so you can see it. Sign up. I'll leave the link down below for all the new folks. Old tribe that you already in has come through. You already know what it is. But right here, a secret. Take a tour. Take a tour. I advise you take a tour. Enjoy your spell space. Connect with other brothers and sisters as you in there. Add your brother as a friend as you dial into the space. And on this space, you have a directory where you go to the side over here. Go to directories. Boom, boom. And you will see other vetted spiritual advisors who have proven that they are about this life. And that's important. We know many of false teachers who ain't true to this. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? So we're going to keep flowing. We got, again, Terrence McKenna. We got Brother Chia, Montauk Chia, Santo Bonacci, Savon, Alan Watts. Man, and all these people I've checked out and listened to. Like, if you just go to YouTube, type in their names. Type in their names. She just had an amazing show with Brother Savon and Brother Kenny, Brother Muji, Brother Dr. Blair. Shout out to all the ancestors. Ah, man. This page is full of amazing brothers, like, and sisters, and so many amazing beings that will give you truth from their rawest perspective and research that they've done over the years. And this right here is an amazing tool to cut out some of the bull, some of the BS that people have been acting as teachers, acting like they're really giving to yourself. But a lot of them have no alternative motives, you know, and that's due to many things. So many people, even the sister here, like, it's so many. It's so many. So dial into this space. When you get a moment, check out the overall right here. Great sister to talk to, full of love, full of energy, and so some people you probably seen, but I would love for you to check out the link down below so we can continue building on it. Also, we know that the world is going through a financial crisis, and if you talking about money and ain't talking about this brother here, you ain't talking about. And if you don't know him, it's because he's probably been censored on YouTube before and they took his joint off. And he had millions of viewers until they slice his, you know, even when they start, he start talking that truth and he start talking that raw. They don't want to talk. They don't want to hear that. And I say they by those who want to keep the status quo. We shattering that. And his brother is Brandon Kelly. Supreme brother. He's a crypto trader. And if you want to know, if you heard about Bitcoin, heard about cryptocurrency, this the guy you want to talk to. This guy has... Did this drop that just happened? I'm going to pull that joint up. I make this quick as possible. I'm trying to make this quick. All right. So this the drop that just happened in cryptocurrency. Try to make this as quick as possible to just get you in the know real quick. Real quick.
Wholeness and balance vibrations, I honor you and your manifestations with wholeness and balance vibrations. Wholeness and balance vibrations, I honor you and your manifestations.
Bam, bam. All right, so this right here, I need to get you a clear one, but you can see it through all my art down there. All right, so this drop right here. In cryptocurrency, and the market dropped 8%, and that's huge for the stock market. Now, those who are tapped into that space, but people are losing their goddamn minds. And crypto dropped too, way more than 100%, couple 8%. But this fall right here, that's 46%. But if I can get it from where it actually. All right, so with Brandon Kelly method, this is when he set up the trend lines and the moving averages. This white line, blue line, red line, and this area down here was all part of the boss method, as he calls it. And simple rule: if the white line passed the blue line, you know what to do. You sell it because you know what's true. And the truth is, whenever it makes that dip, it's highly possible that it might be going down for a little bit. So, if you rock on his method that he gives freely, and even has some courses to take that I suggest going to, I'm in them as well. You check right here when it dropped. The white line went below the blue, somewhere around here. And it stayed down. And you save yourself a 51% drop just by seeing that. Like, oh, it just crossed the blue. Boom, I'm out. So, homie just saved me half of whatever I have in the market, because this, you know, Bitcoin is the honcho. We ain't gonna stay on this too long, because, you know, people get, you know, weary when it comes to cryptocurrency. But again, if you're in the market knowing that the world is going through its largest transition of wealth ever right now, you in the know. We keep it moving. I think let me see if anybody else I wanted to introduce you to. I'll find your brother, me, right here on OneTribe, HMU, as well as other hosts. I'll be hosting some podcasts that's going to be coming up with some amazing people, brothers and sisters that are coming to build with you in real time. And just tune in right here, subscribe, and we'll continue to build on that front. Also, this is Brother Martin Kinney's video right here. He just posted a video today, actually, and it's called Ready Player One. And this dials us into the space that this is just a game. Reminds us that this is but a game. And if you are being played, you're a pawn. But if you're playing the game, meaning you know what's up, you know why certain things are happening, even if you don't know why, just know that this does not determine your future. You determine. You are the captain of your soul, Invictus. And you are it. So you know your power. Know thyself. And this comes with diet, water, energy intake, energy output. Make sure you're getting energy as well, giving energy. You're sharing what you're giving. And being in this space makes you sovereign, just on the physical tip. No, on at steps to it. It's a process to this thing. It's a process. So, but honor the process. Honor the process. Don't think that you are late on knowing some of these things. It's not. Never too late. You are a supreme being. Once your light cuts on, it's your time. And then when you know better, you do better. So start making those steps on those paths to sovereignty, making it happen. All right, so I'm wrapping this up. I ask myself, is there anything else I wanted to share? I did, but I'll share it in the next video. But the next video is definitely going to be revolving around more nature and how to connect with nature in a beautiful way. How to use that right brain, left brain, merge them together. Use your eyes independently. We talk about some third eye exercises and also a game you can play with your kids. And one of those games, they're going to have their phones with them, and they can rock out with their phones and create some amazing things. And we'll talk more about it. It's also, if you want to, again, tap into the game, it's an old book. It's called Just Got It In, and by Harish Johari. And it's the Leela of Self-Knowledge, Yoga of the Snakes and Arrows. And it's an ancient game that expresses the multiplicities of soul, the different hats or roles you wear within this game called life. And that, again, goes back to the spoken word piece that Martin Kinney just posted today. And check it out, Player One, Ready Player One. Great, 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 great spoken word piece from the brother. I'm honored by his energy, his knowledge, and his expression of self, reflection of he, as well as you. Curtis Aru, keep vibing and resonance at top speeds. Next time, we're going to come back to you. We're going to bring you something fresh. We're going to bring you something hot. We're going to bring you something amazing. Oh, this. My music going. Oh, no doubt. Got to get my tones right. Hold up. I got to.